Hello students, and welcome back to another algebra video. You know what to do. Pause the video and answer these questions in your notebook, and then unpause it and let's get started. So, the questions are, do you remember what slope-intercept form of a line is? Do you remember what the equation is for slope-intercept form? And if you do, do you remember what M and B represent? So remember that slope-intercept form is Y equals MX plus B. We're going to talk a lot more about that today. But do you remember what the M and B represent? And then hopefully you tried drawing a picture of a line and seeing if you could label what is M and what is B. What do M and B look like on a graph? If you can do that, that really shows that you truly understand what slope-intercept form is and how it works, what each of the pieces do. So, without further ado, let's get on to our lesson for today. Today we start chapter 4. Section 4.1 is all about writing equations in slope-intercept form. So in the last chapter, we graphed equations in slope-intercept form. Now the focus isn't so much on graphing, it's about looking at a graph or looking at some other information and being able to write the equation. So in chapter 3, we went from the equation to the graph. Now we're going from the graph or other information to the equation. So our learning target is, I remember what slope-intercept form is. So, that is our learning target. Our success criteria is that you can write equations of lines in slope-intercept form using slopes, intercepts, and graphs. So, from graphs to equations and from slopes and intercepts to equations. So, by the end of this lesson, you should be able to write equations using graphs or slopes and intercepts. So, let's get on to what we have. The first thing that we have is a review of slope-intercept form. What does it mean? Remember that slope-intercept form is y equals mx plus b, where m is the slope and b is the y-intercept. So in this example they have here y equals x plus 2. We can see that the x has an imaginary 1 in front of it, right? If we just have x, it means 1x. It's the same thing. So we have a 1 in front of the x, which means that m is 1, and we have plus 2, which means that b is 2, and m is the slope and b is the y-intercept. So that's a quick little example. Let's also look at, this is the same slide from chapter 3 actually. So on a graph, this is what M and B look like. So B, remember, is the y-intercept. It's where the graph crosses the y-axis. That's going to be very important for our lesson today. And you know, it doesn't show it perfectly on this graph, but remember that M is the slope, and slope is rise over run. So if we knew another point on this graph, and we could label, like, down 2 over 2 or something like that, that would help us see what M is. M is the change in Y divided by the change in X. Okay. So, slope-intercept form, y equals mx plus b, that's important. M is the slope, b is the y-intercept, that is also important. And one more thing I'm going to remind you of down here at the bottom. We talked about this in chapter 3, we're going to talk about it again. A linear equation written in the form y equals 0x plus b, so we're talking about the slope is 0. And remember, 0x, 0 times x, that's just 0. So y equals 0 plus b is the same thing as y equals b. And if we have an equation like y equals b or y equals some number, it is called a constant function, and the graph of a constant function is a horizontal line. So remember, horizontal lines have a slope of 0, and they are called constant functions. Okay, I think that's all we need to talk about before we move on to our first example. So, in this example, we are going to use slopes and y-intercepts to write equations. So this is the first part of our success criteria. In the next example, we're going to work on the second part of our success criteria. So, write an equation of each line with the given slope and y-intercept. Okay, well, we know that I can write a line in the form y equals mx plus b. And this video is all about slope-intercept form y equals mx plus b. So they want us to write an equation given that the slope is negative 3 and the y-intercept is 1/2. Well, remember that the slope is m. So m equals negative 3. So I have y equals negative 3x. Don't forget the x. Sometimes I see people just put negative 3 plus b. No. You need that x in there. Okay, otherwise we don't have any inputs, right? X is our inputs. If you just write y equals negative 3 plus b, I don't have an input anymore. So we need to keep the x there. Okay, and what about b? Do I know what b is? Well, yeah, b is the y-intercept. So we have b equals 1/2. So y equals negative 3x plus 1/2. And that's it. This is the equation of a line. Y and x stay in the equation, and m and b get changed for whatever the slope and the y-intercept is. So, our final answer is y equals negative 3x plus 1/2. Okay, see if you can pause the video and do part b on your own. And if you're like, no, please, I don't want to do it by myself, that's okay, you can just keep watching with me. But if you can, try. Try pausing it and trying it on your own. Okay, we want y equals mx plus b. If the slope is 0, that means that m is 0. So we have y equals 0x plus what? Well, the y-intercept, that's b, is equal to negative 2. So, some people write 0x plus negative 2. You don't need to write plus negative 2. You can just write minus 2. 0x minus 2. Okay. But wait a minute. Didn't we just talk on the last slide about how 0x is 0 and 0 plus b is just b? So, when I have 0x minus 2, I can actually just get rid of the 0x. And I can write y equals negative 2. Because remember, 0 times x is the same thing as 0. 0 minus 2, that's just negative 2. So we don't even need to include the 0x part of the equation. And this is a constant function, just like we talked about at the end of the last slide. So, let's check and make sure that we were correct. Y equals negative 3x plus 1/2. Y equals negative 2. Awesome! We were right. Time to move on to our next example. So this is the second part of our success criteria, using graphs to write equations. So in the last example, we used slopes and y-intercepts to make equations. Now we're going to use the graphs to write equations. So write an equation of each line in slope-intercept form. In slope-intercept form, that tells us that we're going to be using y equals mx plus b. So I need to figure out what is m, what is b. And then once I know what the slope is, you know, slope equals whatever, and y-intercept equals whatever, then we can do exactly what we did in the last example. And I can say, oh, m is negative 3, put it right here. B is 1/2, put it right here. So let's figure out what is the slope and what is the y-intercept. Now, let's do the y-intercept first, because personally I think it's a little bit easier. So remember, what is the y-intercept? It's very important that we remember, what is the y-intercept? Well, the y-intercept is the place where the graph crosses the y-axis. So whatever the point is where the graph crosses the y-intercept, that's the point that we want. So in part A, negative 3 is our y-intercept. And in part B, 2 is our y-intercept. So let's write that. Let's write B equals negative 3 and B equals 2. Then we can erase this to clean things up a little bit. So for part A, we're going to have y equals mx minus 3. Because remember, we don't need to write plus minus 3. We can just write minus 3. So now all I have to figure out is what m is. And there are two different ways that we can do this. I'm going to show you the trickier way first, and then I'll show you the easy way second. Because sometimes the trickier way can be, you know, can look scary, but it's not so scary. Okay, so remember that slope is equal to rise over run, which is y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. So we have two points. We can call this point number 1, we can call this point number 2, and look at that. Then we have x1, y1, and x2, y2. And now I can plug these in to figure out what my slope is, just like we did in chapter 3. So my slope, or m, is equal to, and let me get a different color here, y2 is negative 3 minus y1 is 3. Okay. Divided by another color. X2 is 0 minus x1, which is 4. All right, so negative 3 minus 3, so I'm already negative, and I'm getting more negative. That is negative 6. And 0 minus 4 is negative 4. Now, if you left your answer like this, like say when you put it in big ideas or something like that, it would probably tell you that you're wrong. Because, and not because you did the process wrong, but because we can simplify this. If I have a negative on the top and a negative on the bottom, remember that a negative divided by a negative is a positive. So we can actually cancel out those negatives and get positive over positive. And if we look closer, I can divide 6 by 2, and I can divide 4 by 2. So I actually get 3/2. Three halves. So M equals 3/2. And now all I need to do is replace M and B in y equals mx plus b. So y equals 3/2 x minus 3, because b is negative 3. Okay. And if you didn't want to, maybe you wanted to use decimals. Maybe you were like 3/2. Nah, I want to call it 1.5. That would be fine too. Sometimes fractions are easier because it helps us see what is the rise, what is the run. Oh, 3 is the rise, 2 is the run. Whereas if you put it in 1.5, I don't have, I don't have rise over run. I just have a single number. So sometimes we recommend having you keep the fraction because it makes things a little bit easier. Okay, awesome. That is part A. Let's move on to part B. So we already found that our y-intercept was 2. Oh, and you know what? A good idea would be to pause the video and try part B on your own. Try it on your own and then unpause it and see if you were right. So, we already found out that the y-intercept is 2 because it's just wherever the graph crosses the y-intercept. Good. Awesome. Fantastic. So, b is 2, but what is m equal to? Now, in part A, we actually did y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1, and in a future video, we're going to have to do it that way. We're going to have to do it that way because sometimes they're not going to give us the graph, they're just going to give us the two lines. So, it's good to know how to do it this way with the y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. But I want to show you another way that you can do this because m or slope is equal to rise over run. We know that. So instead of plugging in the numbers, you can also, and let me get a different color, you can also just look at the graph closely and you can say, between the two points, how much am I rising? So, to get from this point, the point on the left, to get from the point on the left to the point on the right, I go down 1, 2, 3. I go down 3, which means my rise is negative 3 because I'm going down. Since I'm going down, that's what makes it negative. So I am rising negative 3. And I am running. Remember, run is the x or the horizontal distance. So I am going to the right 1, 2, 3, 4. And I'm going to keep that 4 positive because I'm going to the right. And the positive numbers are on the right, negative numbers are on the left. Okay, so m equals negative 3/4. There you go. Now, if that was confusing to you, no worries. Do it the way that we did in part A. But if you like it better, if you're like, oh, that makes so much sense, then you can do it the way we did it in part B. And remember in the entry task, in the very first slide, when I asked you to show what do M and B look like on a graph? This is what M and B look like on a graph. B is wherever the graph crosses the y-axis, and m is how much we change the y-axis divided by how much we change the x-axis. So, this would be a perfect diagram of what slope-intercept form looks like on a graph. So, that's another reason I wanted to show you how to do how to find the slope using rise over run. Okay, but we're not done yet because I don't have any, excuse me, I don't have an equation. I need y equals mx plus b. So m is negative 3/4. I have y equals negative 3/4, x plus b is 2. Y equals negative 3/4 x plus 2. Okay, there you go. Now, let's check and see if we were right. Okay, find the slope. 3/2, perfect. Y equals 3/2 minus 3. Uh-huh, that's exactly what we got. And slope is negative 3/4. So, negative 3/4 x plus 2. Perfect. Exactly what we did. So we were right. Awesome. That is all I have for you today. We're going to take chapter 4 nice and slow because it is super, super important to understand. Linear functions are everywhere in the world around us. So we're going to take chapter 4 nice and slow. Take this time as an opportunity to rate yourself on a scale of 1 to 3, where 1 is bad, I don't know what's going on, 2 is meh, I need some more practice, but I think I got it, and 3 is, oh, I know I'm going to ace this homework. This makes total perfect sense. Where are you on this scale? And remember, Mrs. Dodge lived at a 1, if not like in between a 1 and a 2. Mrs. Dodge lived there in college, okay? I was always at a 1, or slightly between a 1 and a 2. So do not feel bad if you are a 1. Just make sure that you get your questions answered. So rate yourself. How do you feel about the learning target and the success criteria? Do you think that you have met the success criteria? And if you haven't, please, please, please ask questions. Questions are very good and they help our brain grow. All right, as always, these are some practice problems that you can do to practice the skills you have learned in this video. The first chunk of problems are exactly like example 1, so the very first example that we did. And the second chunk of problems is like example 2, or the example that we just finished. And as always, let's end our video with a launch, shall we? So this launch comes from Martin Luther King Jr., and he says, intelligence plus character. That is the true goal of education. So have you ever thought about what the goal of education is? Have you ever thought about that? Why do we go to school? Why do we learn? Why do we study? Why is education a thing? Well, according to Martin Luther King Jr., it's intelligence plus character. That's what you want to be getting out of school, out of your education. Intelligence plus character. Now, intelligence has to do with how much knowledge you have, how critically you're able to think, how well you're able to reason and problem solving, things like that. What is character? Do you know what character is? Character is about who you are as a person. Do you have integrity? Do you do the right thing even when no one is watching? Are you kind to others? Do you work hard? Your character is who you are at your core, what makes up you and who you are. So the goal of education is to gain intelligence, gain knowledge, get smarter, work out your brain, make it swole and everything, but also character. Develop who you want to be as a person and make sure that you are being a kind, caring person that the world wants to look up to. So that is the true goal of education, or at least what Martin Luther King Jr. thinks the goal of education is. So I encourage you to think Are you getting more intelligent? And are you developing your character? And is your character what you want it to be? Think about those things. That is my launch for you today. Take it with you as you go throughout your day. Have a wonderful rest of your day. And thanks for being here. Thanks for watching. Bye.